Let me begin by, yes, extending my gratitude. I stand here before you as the new sheriff of Maricopa County because of your efforts, because of your confidence, and because of your trust. I thank you for that. Law enforcement and having this authority is a privilege, not an entitlement. So every day when I wake up, I recognize that I must respect this power in the same manner that I respect the law, but most importantly, that I must respect you and how we apply the law. And I take that very seriously. And you heard me mention my wife, and I must state, behind every good man is a much better woman. So first and foremost, I would like to recognize Janet Marghia. I'm not sure where she's seated, somewhere nearby. I was blessed to know her, and just as blessed that her sister Mary was the person to swear me in when I took office. And I know what she does for this organization. Janet's leadership of this organization is tremendous and makes a considerable difference, and I know that you recognize that in your efforts and support is with her. I'd also like to congratulate Petra Falcone, who I've known for quite some time also. I know that she received an award recently, and it is well-deserved. Her efforts are not just about a voice, but about action behind that voice, and it's what I want to speak about today. And lastly, I always recognize my wife, because I will tell you briefly, in 2012 when I first ran, she heard me complaining about my predecessor, and she looked me in the eye and said, "Stop complaining and do something about it." And when your wife takes your man card like that, you have no choice but to step up. And as a man of faith, although we weren't successful in 2012, I thought my path had ended there, and I learned in 2016 that it was not the end of the path when she again looked me in the eye and said, "Finish what you started." So I want to thank you for helping me finish what we started. That leads me to a very powerful quote that I like to reference from Martin Luther King. It is, "Injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere." What was going on in this community, yeah, it's important we recognize that. What was occurring in this community was an injustice, and it required us to stand up together to ensure that we put a stop to it, and it's only the beginning of these efforts. But I feel compelled that all of us as individuals must have the courage to take those types of actions. We have a common belief. We want to demand fair, just, honest, and compassionate efforts within our community. I don't believe change occurs simply by speaking out. I believe speaking out is only the first step. But that first step must be followed by the commitment of actions. Actions to lead by example, to make the commitment to be respectful and forthright. Actions which begin by an investment in first learning. Learning then acting, understanding before speaking, and setting aside self for service. The second paragraph of the Declaration of Independence states, "All men and women are created equal. We are endowed by the Creator with certain inalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness," as you just heard prior to me coming here. It's extremely important who we are and what we stand for. And if we choose to believe in this, we must first commit this right to others before expecting it for ourselves. As a community, we must come together and ensure this right for everyone. It should never be applied subjectively nor partially, nor with bias. It has to be fair to all. Law enforcement is not a division from the community. We are an extension of the community. We have the privilege and the responsibility to ensure that our actions clearly define, reflect, and most importantly, respect the rights of everyone. I believe our community here in Arizona, and I like to speak locally, has the opportunity to show the nation that we're capable of being unified, that we're united as one with many cultures but one community, and that our priority will always be the safety and health of those within our community. And we're a nation of laws and rules designed to protect freedoms provided due to the sacrifices of those who came before us. We can be a strong, safe, law-abiding community and also ensure that everyone has the indelible right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. It's a common theme that we continue to hear because it's truly where we begin. These values can not only coexist, but they must coexist if we're truly committed to equality and respect. I want to share something with you. This morning when I got up, before I got dressed, I actually contemplated, do I wear this uniform or do I put on a suit? Because I knew that if I wore this uniform, many of you would look on to this uniform and it would remind you of either injustices or inappropriate actions carried out by some in this uniform that have worn it, my predecessor. I was actually concerned, as ridiculous as this sounds, that you would judge me because of the color of this uniform. When every day you worry that the people wearing these uniforms in this color will treat you differently because of the color of your skin. I want to stand before you wearing this uniform with pride to let you know that the majority of those men and women in law enforcement care deeply about the community they serve. And although these uniforms may come in different colors, and law enforcement in today's world faces different challenges and conflicts, and often our problems are self-inflicted, that there are great men and women in the Maricopa County Sheriff's Office and throughout the law enforcement communities that want to sacrifice on your behalf with true integrity and ethics. Since taking the office, I have been told that I owe the Latino community an apology for the actions of my predecessor. I've been told that if I don't, I'll be a one-term sheriff. Quite frankly, it's not my responsibility to apologize for my predecessor. It's my responsibility to ensure that I take actions that it should never occur again. I must act in a manner that restores confidence and trust and compassion so that you know my actions will speak far louder than any words that could leave my lips. I didn't pursue this office worried about how I'd keep this job. I wake up every day worried about how I will do the job today, being fair and being just. We're not always going to agree, and I know that. Every decision that I make will not be widely accepted, but I assure you, I will be law-abiding, I will have great respect for the law, I will be constitutional, I will be just, and I will act in a manner that gives respect to those who gave me the authority to have this privilege. I've made considerable changes since becoming sheriff. The pink underwear are on their way out. So that may upset some of you. Excuse me, the tank is long gone, and we are still in the process of getting much closer to the entire closure of Tent City. As, if not more important, I've made changes to the leadership of the Maricopa County Sheriff's Office, not only to establish a sound team, but to ensure that we are aligning skill with character and that all those empowered have the values that I speak of today. As I said, there are good men and women in the Maricopa County Sheriff's Office. They care about you as much as they care about their families. They've embraced a new positive culture. And as your sheriff, I will commit to you that the actions of the past, which were not only tolerated, but were promoted, will never be acceptable for me. The Maricopa County Sheriff's Office will become a committed extension of the community that we serve. We will not be perfect. I will never be perfect. I would not expect that you would. But we will be honest. We will be respectful. We'll be transparent so that you can evaluate and judge our actions. And we will be just. And please remember, when I say we, I am speaking inclusively. I'm your sheriff, you are my community. We're in this together. I cannot accomplish these feats. I cannot change the things outside of my control. We cannot make change on behalf of this community so that it resonates across the nation if we are not in this together in collaboration with patience and respect, perseverance and compassion, and most importantly, the willingness to put actions ahead of words. And it's not just for ourselves, but for the next generation. They deserve better. Words may matter, actions speak volumes. And in closing, I want to thank you for giving me the privilege of being the sheriff of Maricopa County, for being your sheriff, for giving me the privilege and the authority to serve you. I both respect and commend you for your vision here at NCLR, your commitment, your perseverance, and your willingness to every day move the meter a little bit further to make a difference, so that we live in a nation where we're all proud of who we are, where we came from, but ultimately, we all have mutual respect for what is unique about us. I want to close with a quote from Edmund Burke. The only thing necessary for the triumph of evil is for good men and women to do nothing. We refuse to stand by and do nothing. It's an honor to be your sheriff, and thank you.